The U.S. debt is the total sum of all outstanding debt owed by the federal government. As of February 11, 2019, the U.S. national debt was $22 trillion. Two-thirds of that debt is held by the public. The rest is intragovernmental debt. $22 trillion is a lot of money, and it keeps getting higher. One has to wonder if there's any chance that the U.S. will ever pay off its debt. But what if, somehow, the U.S. managed to pay it off? What would that mean for the country itself? That's the question we are asking right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that asks the fundamental questions of life. I'm Charlotte Dobre. Hit that subscribe for more daily questions that will have you asking more questions. If you want to connect with the creative team behind LBQ, check out the description for the links to our social media handles. The United States has the biggest debt in the entire world, $22 trillion. That's almost as big as my student loan. So how was America's colossal debt even created in the first place? National debts are created by too much spending as well as tax cuts. One of the reasons why the US debt is so large is because tax cuts were implemented to try and help those affected by the recession. At the same time, some of the spending was justified. Hurricane Katrina cost the country $24.7 billion. The banks had to be bailed out of $350 billion. Then the US also spends a lot of money on the military. In its entire history, the US has been at war 91% of the time. After 9/11, the US government increased military spending again for the war on terror. This cost $1.9 trillion between 2001 to 2017. If you want to blame US presidents for the debt, here are a couple that created the highest deficits. Franklin D. Roosevelt added $236 billion to the debt. President Obama added $800 billion per year. President Bush had the second largest deficit, but he also had to deal with the financial recession and the war on terror. Reagan also cut taxes, adding to the debt. All four presidents lowered tax receipts as a result of recessions. There was a time when the US wasn't in debt at all. In 1835, the US had no national debt, and it was very low until 1938 when it began to skyrocket. It is difficult to imagine if and how the US will ever pay off its debt. There are only a few ways to do that. First, America would have to cut spending, but by cutting spending, this slows down economic growth. Another way is to raise taxes, which also slows economic growth. And the third way is to drive economic growth more quickly than the rate the debt rises. Republicans and Democrats disagree on how to grow the economy. Democrats say increased spending, Republicans say lower taxes. The government also would have to cut spending on the military and create jobs at home. If the US paid off its national debt, that would mean it wouldn't have to pay back investors the money it owes. Instead, America would be able to spend a lot more money on public services. Things like infrastructure, police and fire services, education and hospitals. If there was no national debt, the economy would grow. People would have money to spend on things like clothes, housing and technology. The United States would become extremely wealthy and extremely advanced. It would have amazing public services and as a result, citizens would have a much higher standard of living. Essentially, everybody would be happier. But most experts think that at this point there's no turning back. It's unlikely that the US will ever pay off its debt. In order to get to the point that the US can spend more money on public services, they would have to cut spending on those things in addition to raising taxes in order to create a surplus. Because the US debt is so massive, it would take years and years of spending cuts and raised taxes for America to get to the point that they can start spending on public services again. Until that happens, public services would suffer, roads would be poorly maintained, government-owned buildings would fall apart. Not to mention, everyone would hate the fact that they're paying more taxes. Until the US managed to pay off its debts, average Americans would suffer. Nobody really wants that. So, most of the world's countries are actually in debt, including America. Despite this, the United States is still an extremely developed country. It has the largest economy in the world, and the most powerful military. The good news is, as long as the US keeps paying off its debt, it will continue to run normally. So not much will happen. But now I open up the question to you, dear subscribers. What do you think would happen if the US paid off its debt? Let me know down there in the comments. For now, I'm gonna read out some comments from my last video, How Do We Stop T-Series. Animated Matter said, what if we hack all phone stores so that when you buy a new phone it's already subbed to PewDiePie? I like the way you think. Texture said, is this one of life's biggest questions? Yes. Yes it is. Miles Monocle said, even life's biggest questions is helping. Always here to help, Miles. Kim Jong-un said, if you want, I can nuke their headquarters. Perhaps that will stop them. Well, Kim, that would definitely stop T-Series, but we at Life's Biggest Questions take no responsibility for such actions. Pijish Rabangshi said, next question, how to stop Life's Biggest Questions? We cannot be stopped. We are LBQ. Welcome to the end screen. This means the video is over. To keep watching this channel, check out the playlist that's currently flashing on your screen. And make sure you leave a like, subscribe, and turn on notifications so I can see you in a future episode of Life's Biggest Questions.